Hi, I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. If you just Googled around because you wanted to learn about GridView and you found that I will tell you about GridView in 3 minutes, I got some bad news for you. If you, on the other hand, is a returning customer here in our series of programming with Qt and QML, I have good news for you. In 3 minutes, I'll tell you the delta between what you know already now and what you need to know to use GridView. Because GridView is very similar to ListView. And for those of you just ending on this page from a Google search, you better go back and watch all the videos that we have on ListView. My grid view is set up like this. First of all, I got a list model. You know what a list model is by now. It has a file, which is the file for the element. It got a name, which is the name for the element that I want to show. I got a component here. My component is what will end up, it's name delegate, that's what's going to end up as my name delegate down here. It's a column, two things on top of each other. First, there's the item source comes from model.file, and it sets up a number of other things here. And I got a text underneath it, and the text is model.name. And then here's my grid view. I fill my grid view as I need to do with any element. I need to make sure that it takes a certain space. I give it some margins. My grid view has a model, name model, that's what we had up here. Delegate, that's the name delegate, that's what we have here. And when I run it, you'll notice there really isn't much to see besides what you expected. The grid view supports flow so that it will flow the items like this. And let's just to convince ourselves that I am not full of that. It really looks very much like what we had in this view. So let me just look at the grid view page here. We have add and add dispatched. That's the animations we saw in the last video. Cache buffer, that's a concept of that will load some pixels before and above our grid view in case that there's lots and lots of items in there. Cell height and cell width, that's new for the grid view here. Count, that's a property where you can go and find how many elements there is in the grid view. We saw that in the list view too. Current index, current item, delegate, same as in the list view. Dispatched, displaced, that's the animation that we saw in the previous video again. Display margin, begin, display margin, end. Remember, that's the concept of blocking that the current item needs to be within a certain area, and so on and so on. Footer, and header, that's the decoration of our grid view. So just scroll down here, you'll notice that almost everything is in here. If I should pick a single one, it would be flow. Flow tells me whether the grid view is laid out like this, or if it's laid out like this, meaning should I start filling rows or should I start filling columns? But that is truly everything that is to be said about grid view. So thank you very much for listening in on this one. In the next video, I'm going to tell you about another view that is almost identical to list view, except that it looks very different. But I'll keep it as a surprise for you what that video is going to be. So until next time, have a great day.